Have you ever wondered what goes into making a glass of milk to make it clean and safe to drink? Perhaps what it takes to stock a supermarket full of burgers, sausages and steaks. Have you ever considered, however, all the microorganisms that could be potentially harmful to our health if left untreated at the appropriate time? In fact, a closer look suggests that the source of contemporary virus infections like Ebola lies in our interactions with animals, both wild and domesticated. Since 1980, more than 87 new zoonotic diseases have been discovered, and they threaten the health of every living being. Zoonotic diseases are diseases passed from animals to humans. Over the last 18 years, we've been faced with more than 15 deadly zoonotic global outbreaks, including Ebola, highly pathogenic avian influenza, Rift Valley fever, and norovirus, apart from others. But it's not just mosquitoes, flies, and bats that transmit these diseases. It's also livestock. Nearly three quarters of the global rural poor and about one third of the global urban poor are dependent on livestock for food, income, manure, and other services. This means that targeting diseases associated with livestock disease is critical to protecting global health. Given the multiple and complex interactions between livestock and disease, why is it that we have failed to understand how livestock owners experienced, conceptualized, and responded to it? The aim of my research is to produce a history from below of livestock health in Britain within the 20th century. I also aim to shift the focus away from government policy and scientific experts to understand how livestock owners understood disease and as to how they coped with it at a time of rapid transition in pharmaceuticals and farming systems. The complex nature of diseases passed from livestock to humans and from animals to animals tells us that there needs to be a greater inclusion of a global One Health agenda in low resource settings. By failing to engage with those who influence our health, manage livestock diseases with chests such as these, and supply the world with food, I feel we're missing something crucial.